subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India celebrates a number of festivals throughout the year. While few festivals are celebrated with equal zeal and enthusiasm across the country, others are restricted to a particular state or area. One among them is Bonnalu, an annual festival observed in the state of Telangana, mainly in its twin cities, Hyderabad and Secunderabad. Though the festival is observed with immense enthusiasm every year, but this year, amid the pandemic, the festive spirit was quite low. Take a look.
Decked in traditional attires and carrying Bonnalu on their head, women in Hyderabad city of Telangana thronged to various temples of goddess Mahakali to celebrate the most auspicious Bonnalu festival. During this occasion, Mother Goddess is worshipped in regional forms like Maisamma, Pochamma and Yellamma. Women make an offering of Bonam, which is prepared using rice cooked with milk and jaggery, along with turmeric vermilion, bangles and sari. Though the festival is observed in a grand manner every year, with processions taking place across the city, but this year, due to the coronavirus pandemic, it was quite a low-key affair. Only 20 to 30 devotees who were provided with a token were allowed to enter the temple at a time.
हर साल अच्छा बना था ये सार गवर्नमेंट आर्डर से कम बना रहे पूरा पब्लिक पूरा रोज डेली एक हफ्ते पहले से ही 20-20 जने को अलाउ कर रहे ये संडे तक
Celebrated in the month of Ashar, Bonnalu is the reflection of Telangana's rich culture and traditions. This year, virus hampered the celebrations, but every year, one could see a number of women marching towards the temples of goddess Mahakali to mark the occasion. Carrying Bonnalu on their head, these women are believed to possess the spirit of Mother Goddess, and when they go towards the temple, people pour water on their feet to pacify the spirit, which is believed to be aggressive. Observed on three different Sundays at different places in the twin cities, Hyderabad and Secunderabad, the festival's origin traces back to the 18th century. It is believed that the festival was first celebrated over 150 years ago following a major cholera outbreak. At that time, military battalion from Hyderabad, which was then deployed in Madhya Pradesh, Ujjain, offered prayers to goddess at Mahakali temple there to get people rid of this menace. And when people got relieved, they started this tradition of installing an idol of goddess Mahakali, which is followed by offering Bonnalu to her.
Sunday they will be not allowed to the temple. That's why we are celebrating before.
Intended to ward off evil and usher in peace, this annual festival is also considered a thanksgiving to the goddess for fulfillment of vows.
As the Indian government is busy battling coronavirus outbreak, a number of citizens and organizations are also not behind in extending their support to the needy people who are worst affected by this pandemic, be it through distributing essential items, study material or oxygen cylinders. People have been contributing their bit without making any discrimination on the basis of caste and community. One such example can be found in Bengaluru city of Karnataka, where an ashram or a spiritual hermitage is distributing food among the needy. Have a look.
In a bid to ward off hunger woes that have worsened with COVID-19 pandemic, various individuals and organizations across the country have come to the forefront to distribute food and grocery items among the needy. Siddhashram, an organization run by a committee of 10 to 15 members, is one among them. Located in the Bengaluru city, this organization has been feeding around 300 people daily amid the pandemic. Every day, people stand in a long queue, patiently waiting for their turn to receive the food items that are provided to them by the ashram. Before they get the food, their hands are sanitized and the thermal screening is also conducted. No matter which caste or community they belong to, if they want to have food, they are all welcomed.
Whoever comes, we are giving. Because sometimes even people who are in PGs, when there are no hotels or any food places to serve, such people also have come and taken food. And it is their greatness because they have to stand in the queue and take. We are not making any separate queue for them. It is a common queue. So we, and here also we don't make any differentiation between caste, creed, rich and poor. But we feed the people because our main aim is hasidavarge anna, bayaridavarge neeru. Means hungry for the, food for the hungry and water for the people who are thirsty. So that we are following.
The ashram has been feeding people for the last 15 years, but earlier the count was just 100. Everything in the ashram is managed via donations, which are further used to serve the society. Presently, it has become a savior for the people who are either running out of food or have lost their jobs during the lockdown.
All the companies are shut down and we don't have work as well as and whatever we have, the money is over. So even though it's very difficult for survive. So just we depend on ashrama or matas, that's all.
At present, when the whole country is reeling due to coronavirus, in such a situation, it's organizations like Siddhashram that are helping the needy people to sustain through these hard times.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
India's premier All India Institute of Medical Sciences or AIIMS Hospital has initiated a plasma donation drive in collaboration with Delhi Police for coronavirus treatment amid rising cases. Those policemen and policewomen who recovered from the deadly virus are now donating plasma to poor patients so that the shortage for plasma therapy doesn't arise.
जो हम ट्रीटमेंट अभी दे रहे हैं कोविड का, ज़्यादातर सपोर्टिव ट्रीटमेंट है. उसमें जो कन्वलेसेंट प्लाज्मा है, जो लोग ठीक हो गए उनका जो प्लाज्मा है उसकी हम जांच करते हैं, और अगर उसमें एंटीबॉडीज़ हैं जो वायरस को मार सकती हैं तो वो प्लाज्मा जब हम किसी व्यक्ति जो कोविड से सफ़र कर रहा है उसको दें, तो ये एक माध्यम है जिससे हम कुछ हद तक और दवाइयों के साथ कोविड की लड़ाई में पेशेंट की जान बचा सकते हैं।
Plasma is a component which once extracted from blood and separated from the red blood cells, the RBCs are returned to the body. India has more than a million total COVID-19 cases, out of which 6,77,422 have recovered, who can contribute to plasma donation.
As many as 167 Indians who were stuck in Sharjah due to the coronavirus pandemic returned to Amritsar city in Punjab. The citizens who could not fly back to India due to the lockdown, as international flights were suspended from March 22 to prevent the spread of coronavirus, landed on Sri Guru Ram Das Ji International Airport.
ਪਰ ਉੱਥੇ ਆ ਲੌਕਡਾਊਨ ਲੱਗਣ ਕਰਕੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਲ ਆ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਅਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਵਾਪਸ ਬੁਲਾਉਣ ਰਹੇ ਤਾਂ ਵਾਪਸ ਛੇਤੀ ਆਇਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਾਂਦਾ। 2-3 ਮਹੀਨੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਹੁਣ ਟਿਕਟ ਮਿਲੀ ਆ ਅਤੇ ਆਏ ਆ, ਅਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਹ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਅੱਗੇ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਵੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਹੋਰ ਵੀਰ ਫਸੇ ਆ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਜਲਦੀ ਤੋਂ ਜਲਦੀ ਉਪਰਾਲਾ ਕਰਕੇ ਕੋਈ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਵਾਪਸ ਲਿਆਵੇ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਹਰ ਇੱਕ ਘਰਾਂ 'ਚ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਮਾਪੇ ਡੀਕਣ ਰਹੇ ਆ।
The passengers who were stuck without work and money were happy to return to their country through a special flight.
Doctors at India's largest hospital treating coronavirus patients are prepared for a second wave of the virus as the number of infections in the country exceeded 1 million. The government-run Lok Nayak Jayaprakash Narayan Hospital has been at the forefront of Delhi's fight against the pandemic, having treated over 6,000 patients suffering from COVID-19 disease caused by the novel coronavirus. Around 4,000 of these were successfully cured of the virus, according to the hospital's medical director Suresh Kumar.
So we have prepared, we have the enough number of ICU beds, we have enough number of semi-ICUs and HDU beds, we have enough number of oxygen beds, so we can manage even if we have the larger number and secondary waves comes, then we have very excellent facility, very good facility, and we are prepared for that.
Until a few months ago, as the pandemic had started to sweep Delhi, the hospital had been scrambling to find enough beds or equipment to treat the hundreds of patients piling up.
In Vadodara city of Gujarat, an ice cream parlor is catching the fancy of visitors with its immunity-boosting ice cream. Made up of the ingredients which are especially used in making kadha, a herbal homemade medicine, these ice creams are turning out to be delicious alternatives.
हमने काढ़ा का सारा मटेरियल आइसक्रीम में डाल के आइसक्रीम बनाया और उसमें हमने यूज किया है तुलसी, फुदीना, आदू, लविंग, बादाम, काली मरी, तज, आंवला जैसे प्रोडक्ट यूज किए हैं जो शरीर में शक्ति बढ़ाने के लिए काफ़ी अच्छे हैं। और ये आइसक्रीम आयुर्वेदा आइसक्रीम है, तो आयुर्वेदा आइसक्रीम छोटे बच्चों से लेके वडिल वर्ग सभी को खूब पसंद आ रहा है और डे बाय डे हमारे कस्टमर का रिस्पांस भी काफ़ी अच्छा मिल रहा है, फीडबैक भी काफ़ी अच्छा मिल रहा है।
Amid the pandemic, people across the country are coming up with several such creative ideas in order to boost the immunity.
India has begun human trials of coronavirus vaccine in Rohtak city of Haryana. The trials come on the day the number of coronavirus cases crossed 1 million in India. Bharat Biotech's COVID-19 vaccine had been approved for human trials earlier. It is India's first domestic candidate to get the green light from the government's drug regulator as cases surge in a country with more than 1.3 billion people.
आज हमने 3 सब्जेक्ट्स को ह्यूमन ट्रायल के लिए एनरोलमेंट किया है और शुरू में ये जांच किया गया कि उन्होंने इस वैक्सीन को बहुत अच्छे से टॉलरेट किया है और उनके अंदर कोई भी इसका एडवर्स इफेक्ट नहीं आया।
कोवैक्सीन वॉज डिवेलप्ड एंड मैन्युफैक्चर्ड इन भारत बायोटेक्स फैसिलिटी इन जीनोम वैली इन हैदराबाद इंडिया। The Drug Controller General of India had approved the company's application to conduct a Phase 1 and 2 clinical trial of Covaxin, which was developed along with the Indian Council of Medical Research National Institute of Virology. After 14 days, a second dose would be given to the patients, after which the adverse effects of the vaccine, if any, would be studied along with how much of antibody level is produced.
Amid this time of pandemic, every community in India is rising above religious lines to help the society in one or the other way. A similar example can be witnessed in the Agra city of Uttar Pradesh, where the Sikh community has taken the initiative to make masks out of the turbans and distribute them among the needy.
For a Sikh, his turban is more than a headgear. It is an identity, a symbol of spirituality, pride and honor, and presently, during this COVID-19 crisis, these turbans of Sikhs are also becoming a lifesaver, all because of an initiative by the members of the community. In Agra city of Uttar Pradesh, Sikhs under the banner of Sukhmani Seva Sabha have started the mission Turban for Mask, in which masks are being made from the old turbans collected from various households, which will then be distributed among the needy people.
ये जो कोरोना की महामारी ये पूरे विश्व में जो ये दुख की घड़ी आई है उसको देखते हुए एक कॉमन चीज जो मास्क है वो आज हर इंसान की जरूरत बन गई है। सबसे बड़ी हम अपनी देखभाल इस मास्क के द्वारा कर सकते हैं। तो एक विचार मन में पैदा हुआ कि टर्बन फॉर मास्क, जो एक पगड़ी आन बान शान है, जब पुरानी पगड़ी हो जाती हैं तो कई बार वह हम उनको यूज में नहीं ले पाते, तो इस बात को मद्देनजर रखते हुए कि वो पगड़ियां किस काम में आ सकती हैं, अच्छे काम में, इस बात को मद्देनजर रख के समूह सुखमणि सेवा सभा और विशेषकर हमारे जो लेडीज विंग हैं सभी ने ये विचार किया कि पुरानी पगड़ी इकट्ठी करके उनके मास्क बना करके हम इसका निशुल्क वितरण हर एक इंसान को करें जिसको इसकी जरूरत है।
बोथ मैन एंड वुमेन ऑफ द सिख कम्युनिटी आर टेकिंग दिस मिशन फॉरवर्ड एंड हैव केप्ट अ टारगेट ऑफ अराउंड 1 लाख मास्क। During this time of virus outbreak, as masks have become an important protective gear, its demand is touching new heights. By distributing it for free among the people, irrespective of their caste and faith, Sikh community is setting a precedent.
हम लोग का 1 लाख मास्क का टारगेट है और घर घर में हम लोग लेडीज मिलकर ये सब काम कर रहे हैं।
डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन
किया जाएगा इसका, ये इस माह के एंड तक जो है हमारी कोशिश है कि हम लोग अपना टारगेट अचीव कर लें। सब लगे हुए हैं और एंड तक जो है वो वितरण करेंगे इसका।
जस्ट लाइक द सिख कम्युनिटी, पीपल ऑफ अदर कम्युनिटीज आर ऑल्सो कमिंग फॉरवर्ड एंड हेल्पिंग इन द मास प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मास्क एंड अदर प्रोटेक्टिव गियर्स, thus serving their own bit in the fight against the novel coronavirus.
Amid the COVID-19 pandemic, artists have found a number of new ways to reach out to the audience. Putting artworks online by the medium of virtual exhibitions or online art platforms is becoming quite popular nowadays. It is not just giving artists a platform to carry on with their artistry, but is also providing them with much needed motivation and consistency. Have a look.
Amid difficult times like these, artists and creators around the world are figuring out different ways to showcase their creativity to the world, and going virtual is one such method. To break out from the stagnation of the pandemic and to exhibit artworks and paintings, virtual exhibitions are being organized that are providing a common platform to artists and buyers. Anusuya Sharma from Delhi is one such artist who decided to go virtual in order to showcase her paintings.
जो वर्चुअल गैलरी है ये बहुत हेल्प करती है आपको, आप अपना आपको मोटिवेटेड भी रखती है, आप काम भी करिए और अपना प्रेजेंट भी कर सकते हैं काम. एंड यस, जो रोज़मर्रा की लाइफ है वो अब पहले जैसी नहीं है, बहुत चेंजेस आ चुके हैं. बट यस, वी हैव टू ओवरकम, वी हैव टू, इस सिचुएशन से हमें निकलना ही है और करना ही है.
अ टीचर बाय प्रोफेशन, painting is Anusuya's passion, and presently she has started selling them online. Amid the pandemic, online exhibitions are providing great opportunities to artists to showcase their work. Even art enthusiasts can see these virtual galleries by sitting at the comfort of their home and appreciate the artworks. Websites like Absolute Arts are conducting a number of virtual exhibitions nowadays, providing a common platform to both artists and buyers.
Absolute Art ने एक platform बनाया है जहाँ पे हम जाके अपनी paintings को project कर सकते हैं, present कर सकते हैं. अगर आप बड़े brands में जाइए या exhibitions में जाइए तो they charge very high अमाउंट इन थाउजेंड्स कि आप वहाँ पे अपना प्लेटफॉर्म पे अपनी कोई आर्ट वर्क प्रेजेंट कर सकें. बट एब्सोल्यूट आर्ट इज़ वेरी इजी प्लेटफॉर्म जहाँ पे आप जा सकते हैं, अपना आर्ट दिखा सकते हैं, प्रोजेक्ट कर सकते हैं.
ड्यू टू सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग नॉर्म्स, नो एग्जीबिशंस आर बीइंग हेल्ड अराउंड द कंट्री एंड ऑल आर्ट गैलरीज आर करेंटली क्लोज्ड. देयरफॉर virtual exhibitions like these are providing a great opportunity to the budding talented artists to present their artworks.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ain.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.